Although totem carving used to be about recording history, it's now more and more about preserving it. Many totems, which used to dot our downtown area, have met their match, succumbing to the elements after being exposed to them for years. Because the natives had no written language in the early to mid-1800s, oral history was passed down from generation to generation. The totems preserved that oral history by depicting many of the stories of the Indian people. The loss of that history as these poles slowly deteriorate has long been a concern of local native elders. In addition to the deterioration of poles located in populated areas, many old Tlingit and Haida village sites near Ketchikan had been abandoned, with many poles carved in the 19th century still standing. To rescue those poles, as well as preserve the native history associated with pole carving, the Totem Heritage Center was established in 1976. Some natives living in remote areas had a strong desire to be close to churches and schools, but more particularly employment. Canneries, sawmills, and mines provided good employment and were always looking for help. As many natives moved away from subsisting off the land, employment became essential to being able to support themselves and their families. With little or no employment opportunities in their remote Indian villages, many small communities were abandoned as its inhabitants made their way to the city, leaving their totems behind as one of the only reminders of their existence. The Alaska State Museum, in conjunction with the Alaska Native Brotherhood, received permission from Native elders to visit former Native village sites at Tongass Island, Village Island, and Old Kasan, and retrieve standing totems that had been left behind. Aided with technical assistance from the U.S. Forest Service and the Smithsonian Institute, the poles made their way to their permanent homes in the Heritage Center. It's actually quite amazing that many of those poles were preserved at all. Mistaking the poles for religious idols, early Christian missionaries told their Indian converts to burn the poles. The poles, in fact, were not religious in nature at all, but were actually more like a billboard or tombstone, telling a story or relating historical facts. The poles were also essential in the establishment of family identity. And although a status symbol within the native community, were not worshipped as was originally believed. Anthropologists recognize six different types of totem poles. The potlatch poles celebrated festivals and special events, and were usually the largest of all totem poles. Mortuary poles were built with a small opening in the back to hold the ashes of the deceased. However, the practice of cremating decreased with the conversion to Christianity in many villages, and mortuary poles became less and less common. House poles, often carrying the family emblem, were used to support rafters both inside community and clan houses and outside for support and stability. Heraldic poles displayed tribal and family history and proclaimed the lineage and social standing of a family, in a similar way that a family crest was used by the Europeans. Memorial poles were made in honor of the dead, usually highlighting the life of an important elder or tribe member. The one place a person didn't want to end up was at the top of a ridicule pole. Such poles targeted high-standing authority figures for their lack of leadership, or others who had failed to fulfill an obligation or pay a debt. Totem poles in Southeast Alaska are usually made of cedar, specifically red cedar, and traditionally were made with tools made of wood, bone, beaver teeth or antlers, and attached to handles with rawhide, tree roots, or sinew. Before the arrival of the Europeans, totem poles were painted with simple colors mixed from salmon eggs to make black with charcoal, red with iron ore, and blue with copper oxides. Although most paints used today are purchased from a local hardware store, artists tend to stick to traditional colors. Most of the figures carved on totem poles are animals or mythological beings symbolizing a particular group's history that has been passed down through the generations. It is impossible to read a totem pole because the true meaning was only known by the artist that carved the pole and told to those that were present at the pole's raising. It is possible, however, to identify crests which were helpful to a stranger entering a village looking for a certain person or family. The fact we can still enjoy totems and their stories is due in large part to the continued work of modern-day totem pole carvers, in conjunction with preservation of the past through efforts like those taking place at the Totem Heritage Center. In addition to preserving totem poles, the Heritage Center has also committed itself to the preservation of Native culture in general. Native language and art classes, open to both Natives and non-Natives alike, are now an integral part of the Center's mission. During the cruise ship season, the Center is open daily from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Admission is $5. In addition to the historical displays, modern Native art has also been included as part of the Center's collection. The preserved totem poles and artifacts inside may be in various states of decay, but their history is as rich and colorful as ever.